Hallelujah in the eyes. Bless the name of the Most High God for making it possible for me to see this beautiful and glorious day. I want to remind you again that Jesus Christ is coming very soon. Are you prepared? You should come back suddenly today. Are you going to reign with him in the heavenly places? Or are you going to be cast into the lake of fire? That's why I'm telling you this day that you should repent of your sins and accept him as your Lord and as your Savior. As we all know that he is the way, the truth, and the life. Nobody can come unto the Father except by him. Nobody will be able to inherit the kingdom of God except you accept Jesus Christ as your Lord and as your Savior. Are you working right now? Are you a civil servant in your place of work? Hope you are not involved in bribery and corruption that is rampant nowadays. You find out that in almost all establishments, all governmental institutions nowadays, you have what we call ghost workers. Some officials, they have up to 10, 20 ghost workers. They cash out at the end of every month. If only you are collecting money for 20 people that are not working, that is corruption. That is not godly. You have to repent of all these evil hearts and accept and ask Jesus Christ for forgiveness of sins and accept him as your Lord and as your Savior. I want you to remember that the Bible says that verily, verily, I say unto you, except a man is born again, cannot see the kingdom of God. And what shall it profit a man if he should gain the whole world and lose his own soul? Or what shall he give in exchange for his soul? Or you think the amount of money matters to God? The amount of money you have does not matter to God at all. What matters to him is your salvation, the salvation of your soul. Have you forgotten that it's because of love, of the love God had for us? He's still having that love for us. That was why he sent Jesus Christ, his son, who died on the cross of Calvary for the sins of the whole world. His blood was shed on the cross of Calvary for all our sins. Whether you are green, you are blue, you are brown, whatever you are, Jesus Christ has paid the price for your sins. But you have to accept him. You have to realize that he has done a great work for you, a great work of salvation for your soul on the cross of Calvary. It's time for you to repent of your evil ways. Repent. Ask him for forgiveness. No matter what you have ever done wrong, he is ready to accept you if you repent. Ask him for forgiveness of sins and accept him as your Lord and as your Savior. You confess him as your Lord and as your Savior. The Bible says, with the heart man believeth unto righteousness, and with the mouth confession is made unto salvation. You have to change your evil ways this day. Tomorrow might be too late. This year is going to an end. You know, when did we start this year? We are very soon, we shall be entering the third month. It's going to an end. What legacy do you want to leave behind? You have to repent this day. Repent this day. Tomorrow might be too late. Do you want to be known at the end of everything in this world as a godly man? Or they will just publicize that you are a good man. At the end of the day, they will be saying behind your back that you are evil in deeds and in thoughts. It's better you do the right thing. Are you a professor in a university? Are you a doctor in any establishment? Are you a teacher? Are you a lawyer? Are you a politician? Politician is not even an occupation. No, what we are saying, what I'm saying to you this day is that if you are involved in anything evil, you have to repent. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. You may do evil on this earth, that you will use another person because of your position. You use other people to take your punishment on this earth. You and the security officials, you pally together. You sent another person to jail just for what you did. This will not happen in heaven. You have to repent. And all your evil deeds, if you did not repent of them, you are going to be punished on this earth, and at the same time be punished in heaven. You have to repent. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. All the evils you have been doing, maybe you want to have money, you involve yourself in bribery and corruption, you sleep with young girls around, you are involved in fornication, adultery, things like that. You have to repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Repent. All these things will never satisfy you. You can never get satisfaction. That's why you see even the richest men in this world, they give at the same time, they are looking for more. They will never be satisfied. The only thing that can satisfy you is your salvation in the Lord Jesus Christ. If you have salvation in the Lord, truly have salvation in the Lord Jesus Christ, you are going to have peace of mind. You won't be running helter-skelter about what is not. I'm not saying you should not walk, you should walk, but not running helter-skelter, do or die. Like what they used to say, that if you cannot beat them, you join them. In the kingdom of God is at hand. You have to repent. Don't join evil gangs. Join the gang of the Lord Jesus Christ. Come into the group of the Lord Jesus Christ. He's calling unto you. It's the only way to God the Father. In the Bible says that for their salvation in order, there's no other name given among men under heaven that we might be saved. It's only one that can save you. It's only one that died on the cross of Calvary because of the sins of the whole world. Jesus, a lot of people will say Jesus Christ is just a prophet. No, Jesus Christ is not just one of the prophets, or is just a prophet. Jesus Christ is the prophet. Jesus Christ created the whole wide world. Jesus Christ created everything, even you included. He is God himself. That's why we say we have God the Father, God the Son, God the Holy Ghost. Yeah, Jesus himself said, that I am in the Father. The Father is in me. It's just like that. You cannot separate them. That's why you call them three in one. God is Jesus. Jesus is God. He is calling unto you. Repent, for the kingdom of heaven is at hand. Jesus loves you. I am Omo Jesu, Prophet Peter Oluremi Omondara of Ancient of Days Apostolic Ministries. Till next time we meet, Jesus loves you. Shalom.